You can see the beautiful moringa leaves in the dosa. Dosa is slightly brown, yellow in color, and slightly thick. So let's taste the Sanna Pollo now. What's up guys, welcome to Chomping Champion. Main hu aapka dost Anoop Kamath. In the last episode or the first episode of Konkani Food, I showed you how to make Atsara Pollo, a very simple recipe made of rice and coconut. Today we are going to modify that recipe. We are going to add few ingredients and we are going to make it more colorful and more nutritious. One ingredient which we are going to add to the batter is moringa leaves. This is sahajan ke patte. Actually, sahajan ki phali or the drumstick we use in lot of curries and sabjis, particularly in Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Kerala. The drumstick sambar is famous. But I will say that the drumstick is completely underutilized. The bark of the tree can be used as a tenderizer. The flowers are used by certain communities to make beautiful sabji. And today we are going to use the leaves of moringa. We are going to add into the batter and going to make it more nutritious, because moringa is superfood. It is good for your heart, it's good for your internal organs like liver and kidneys, it reduces your BP, it's good for your skin and whatnot. I will give a complete list of medicinal properties of moringa in the description box below. But we'll go ahead with the recipe, so we'll head to the kitchen and straight away start cooking. This dosa with the moringa leaves is called Sanna Pollo in Konkani. I don't know what Sanna means, but that is the common term which is used. Normally to Sanna Pollo, cabbage, finely chopped cabbage is added. Cabbage actually makes this dosa more crunchy and more interesting. I have not heard about any community making cabbage dosa. But today we are going to add moringa leaves, because moringa leaves are available in this season and it certainly makes the dosa more nutritious. Moringa leaves are slightly bitter, but they impart a completely different and interesting flavor to this batter. So let's see what ingredients we require for making Sanna Pollo. So we have 1.5 cup of idli rice, which is soaked for 2 hours. We have drained the water. And then we have coconut. So for 1.5 cup of rice, we are going to take 1/2 cup of coconut. I've cut the coconut into small pieces. We need 7 to 8 red chilies. You can see the red chilies here. We need 2 tablespoons of imli pulp. This is a small lemon sized tamarind soaked in the water, in slightly warm water, and you leave it for 15 minutes. You squeeze the contents and you get the pulp. And of course we have moringa leaves. Just see how beautiful these leaves are. It's a bit of a task to clean the leaves. We have to remove the stems, because stems are quite bitter, but these leaves are cleaned and washed. You don't have to make them dry, because we are going to put them in the batter. So apart from these ingredients, what we require is 1/2 teaspoon of hing, little bit of turmeric powder, 1/4 teaspoon, and salt according to your taste. So let's start grinding the soaked rice first. So we'll transfer the rice, which is soaked in water for a couple of hours, into this. I think we will do it in 2 batches. If it is required, you can add little bit of water. I'm adding little bit of water. I think that's enough. And we'll grind it. So we have ground the first batch of soaked rice. Just see the consistency. I'm going to pour this into a bowl. It's quite thick. It is slightly thicker than the dosa batter. This is the consistency we are looking for. So now we'll grind the rest of the rice and then the coconut. So now we are going to add coconut into the same grinder bowl. We don't have to wash it. Just transfer all the coconut into this. It has been cut into small pieces so that it evenly grinds. And the red chilies, just break them into 2 pieces. we will add about 2 tablespoons of tamarind pulp, imli juice. I'm adding little bit. If you need more, we can add it later to the batter. We will also add about 1/2 teaspoon of haldi and add little bit of water. And then we are going to grind it into a nice fine paste and then add it to the rice batter. You can see the consistency of the coconut paste. It is almost like a chutney. We didn't add a lot of water, little bit of water. Little by little you can add water. Now the imli water, the coconut and the red chilies with little bit of turmeric is ground into a very fine paste. So let's add this into the batter. So here goes the coconut paste. You may wonder whether it's little too thick. We can actually add more water and adjust the consistency of the batter. But first, let's get all this into the rice batter. Let's give it a nice mix and see. I'm mixing it well so that it's a uniform mixture. I think the batter consistency is quite nice. It has to mix well so that it's a uniform golden color. Yeah, now we can add little bit of salt and hing. I'm adding salt. 1.5 teaspoons should be enough. And 1/2 teaspoon of hing. I'm just using powdered hing. I think that should be fine. Give it a mix again. Our batter is ready, but we have to add our main ingredient, that is moringa leaves. So let's add little by little. I have added 2 handfuls of moringa leaves. Let's give it a stir and see whether this is enough. I think little bit more. I think this should be enough. The moringa leaves are quite good to store in the refrigerator. I actually cleaned it and kept it in the refrigerator for 3 or 4 days and they're still green and very fresh. They can last for a couple of weeks. Even if they wilt or even if they're slightly dry, you can rehydrate them and add this to the batter and make dosas, sanna polo. But the fresh leaves are always good. The consistency of the batter is very good. Now we'll make the dosas. Before making the dosa, just with a silicone brush, apply a little bit of oil. About 1/2 teaspoon. Actually, the dosa is to be made in the way you make the normal dosa. But here the batter is thick and you will get a thick dosa. So you can't get a very crispy dosa here. It'll be crispy on the outside, it'll become brown, but it'll be thick. Just spread it lightly and gently. And you can cover it with a lid. So it's about a minute and I think dosa is cooked on one side. Let's just flip it. Yeah, you can see the brown color. We don't have to make it dark brown. This color and texture is what we are looking in sanna polo. We have to just keep it on the tawa for about 30 seconds or 35 seconds, and the second side also will be done. You can see this beautiful green leaves, moringa leaves. When you feel that the dosa is cooked on both sides, just fold it and transfer it into a plate or a casserole. So we had tried making one dosa earlier. This is the second dosa. We'll make one more and then we'll taste the dosa. So we have to use one ladle of the batter, or maybe a one and a half ladle of batter. Not more, because you cannot make a big dosa. The dosa will be about 6 to 8 inches in diameter, and it will turn out quite well and it will be easy to flip. The steam cooks the dosa fast. Now we'll give it a flip. Make it slightly brown on the other side. Actually, you can see the dosa is golden brown on this side. You can see it now. So our third dosa is also done. Now we will taste the sannapur. So our sanna polo is ready with moringa leaves. Just see how the dosa looks like. I'll open the dosa and show you. You can see the beautiful moringa leaves in the dosa. Dosa is slightly brown, yellow in color and slightly thick. So let's taste the sanna polo now. I'll first taste the dosa on its own, the sanna polo. A small piece of dosa. This dosa, sanna polo, is unique. The prominent taste is that slight bitterness, and there is a taste of moringa leaves which I can't explain. Also, that slight sourness of the tamarind, sweetness of the coconut, and all the other ingredients which have gone inside, it has blended beautifully. And this dosa is very different from atsara polo, but a great dosa to have for breakfast and a very healthy option too. I am going to take another bite of this dosa with gunpowder. We call it idli powder or mulagai podi. Little oil is mixed with the podi. You can have a look. Here is the bite of the dosa with the podi. Podi means powder. You can see the bite. With the podi, this dosa is superb. You can use coconut chutney or tomato chutney or sambar with sanna polo, with moringa leaves, or you can use podi. Podi can be stored for a long time in your refrigerator or even outside. If you want the recipe of the podi, I'll give it in the description box below. But this combination certainly works, and you got to try this dosa with moringa leaves. Sanna polo with moringa leaves. If you want to see more recipes like this, keep watching my channel. Till the next episode, bye. Take care and stay healthy.